Hi everyone, welcome to Python Linux CISO Network Engineers. This is the third video on logging. This is one of the subtopic in overall Python learning series in the channel. In the second video, we have seen how to create handlers in Python logging. You can see here, I have created two file handlers and one stream handler. File handlers are storing logs into these two log files, which is debug and above and info and above in the another file, and stream handler will store it into the terminal. Here we started logging the messages. Here we are logging, connecting to the device and the username details, and let's log the message here. Once connection is successful, we will just log it as connected successfully. Once we get the session established, we'll just log the message saying that connected successfully. After that, the command execution part here. Here we are executing the command as show version. So before that, we'll just log a message here. Executing the command show version. And after that, we'll be receiving output here. We are storing the output into the variable output. So let's log a message here. And if you see here, what I'm doing here, once I receive output, I'm just logging a message saying that received output. After that, creating another logger with the debug and above message, and here I'm just printing even the output data. So my log message, the output message, the configuration file will go only to the debug. So let us try running it. So you can see my debug and info file now. Let us try running it now. So this has finished the execution. We can see now here in info, I'm getting initializing the script, connecting to the device, username details. Once connection is successful, it is showing it and executing the command. Here in logger, it is in the info level, it is showing only till received output. But if you see here in the debug, it is even storing the terminal output here. So you can just keep the track of configuration and all in this way in a debug file. Debug will have more information. Now let us log each parsed output. Here you can see I'm getting the version result, and that version result I'll try logging here. So for that, logger.info, and then I'll give version result similar to that. Logger.info model result, the model result, because the past output I'm storing in model result and logging it here. Logger.info serial number result, and here hostname result. Up time result, and once we complete the execution, we'll just print a message here: successfully completed the command execution. And here in exception part, once we get an authentication exception, what we can do, we can just define a level here. First we will set it as a warning, and we'll just print the message: authentication failed. And here if we get any attribute error, the parsing error, for example, if you execute show run here, the parsing logic will fail. At that time we'll get an error. So for those kind of errors, so that will come under attribute error, and those kind of errors, what I'll do, logger dot, here I'll make it as error, and we'll give a message: parsing error, check the command, and I'll give a slash in here. And similar to that, if we are not able to connect to the device, I'll just log it as logger.critical, and I'll just print unable to connect, and we'll give a slash in here. So let us try running this script now. If you want, we can delete existing log files. Okay, we have received the log files here. Let us open info, and here now it is logging, connecting to the device username, and it is adding all the parsed output here as info, and successfully completed the script execution. And if you see here in debug, we can see even the terminal output. Now let us try another case where authentication failed. So let me just give admin one, and now I should get authentication failed message. Yeah, I'm getting authentication failed, and it is even printing in the terminal because of the stream handler. Let's see here. Yeah, we are getting here as well. It is as warning. Here also we are getting it. Now similar to that, if we just give test 123.lab, so we're getting the message unable to connect, and that is showing us critical. Now if I set the minimum logging level of stream handler to info, let's see what will happen. We can see in each stage my stream handler is printing the message. So the minimum level what you set for each handler will take the priority over this level of individual the logger. I'll change this to warning, And if you don't set any level by default for any logger or handler, by default it will be warning. Now let us see one of the parsing error. Here I'll change the command to show run. Let me try running the script. Yeah, we're getting the message parsing error, check the command. And in info also we are getting this, but if you see the debug, we'll be getting complete show run command what we executed. I hope now you got a clear understanding on how to enable logging and how to add handlers in Python logging module and save it into a log file with different levels and different minimum logging levels and different destinations like file system and stream handler. And in the next video we'll see how to log this into an email, how to send an email if any event occurs. I hope this video was helpful. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.